Welcome. Today we meet the 2020 captain of the Polk State flight team, Justin Gentle. My name is Carl Valeri, and I'm the coach of the Polk State flight team. Justin was captain during our first season at the regional competition at Lakeland Linder International Airport. First time we had it there. We're really excited to have him join us for this meet here at Meet the Team video right here. And hey, welcome, Justin. It's great to see you.
It's great to see you too, Carl.
You know, one of the things that I think is really important is for folks to realize that Polk State flight team helps people quite a bit. And if you're listening to this or watching it on YouTube, do me a favor, check out the website at some point, polkstateflightteam.com. And we have all the information about all the team members and what we do, when the competitions are, and where maybe you can watch us actually compete. Or if you have somebody that's interested in getting involved in a flight team at a collegiate program, this will actually help you understand what it's all about. Also, if you can, we always could use help. There's a donate button that's on the page there. It really helps. Every little bit helps. Just $1, $2, whatever it may be, helps us move forward with the competition, also with actually training and practicing. But anyway, without further ado, again, it's captain of the 2020 team, Justin Gentle. He's competing this year, and it's great to see you, Justin. This is awesome. And that's you got to introduce our friend.
This is Talon. I kind of maybe kidnapped him when I came back to Los Angeles, but he's been enjoying the warm SoCal weather with me.
Well, you know, remote learning is actually one of those things that has become very popular and necessary lately. And it's funny you said that in California. Here we are. I'm in Lakeland, Florida at Lakeland Linder International Airport, where we had the regional competition. And you're actually in Southern California. And it's actually one of the reasons that we're talking about this is that even though we are actually having to social distance, competition goes on, doesn't it?
Sure does.
So, Justin, tell us a little bit about your career aspirations and how you actually got involved in the aviation world.
Sure thing. It's one of those weird stories that I can piece together looking back on it, but I wouldn't have ever been able to see it unraveling. Living in Orlando, I always watched the space shuttle. Always, like 2 a.m, wake me up, we're going to watch it, step outside, we can see it. And apparently, even in Christmas cards and things, I was going to be an astronaut at the age of 2. I go up, up, up. What does that mean? That's baby talk. But I've always wanted to be an astronaut. The space program, whether that's NASA going to the moon, or nowadays, the realistic prospect of even becoming a commercial space captain, flying from Australia to New York suborbitally in 2 hours. And, you know, you laugh when you think, oh, you still want to be an astronaut? Isn't that what kids want to do? But only adults have been to space. We don't send kids to space. I, of course, am interested in the airlines, in aviation, whether it's smaller seaplanes, grand caravans, or even an Airbus A320. And I would love to work and fly larger airplanes, passengers, people, get to share aviation. If you offered me a space job, I'll take it in a heartbeat, but I would be just as happy at an airline.
Awesome. So you're wide open to everything in aviation, but it sounds like you really are somebody who's passionate about aviation. We'll get a little bit into that, but first of all, before we talk about the team, what brought you to Polk State College?
Polk State College, yes. Well, I was in a Calculus 2 exam in an aerospace engineering degree, thinking the entire time, what can I do that's not aerospace engineering? Turned in the exam 2 hours early, unfinished, because I had decided I was going to learn to fly rather than design the airplanes. I, at the time, only thought Embry-Riddle was the opportunity for college aviation, and I went there. I earned my private pilot certificate in Daytona Beach. And I had no more money. I could not continue my college aviation experience. I took a semester off. I moved back home with my parents, and I searched every college in the United States that had a aviation program. I ended up at Polk State. And there's a couple reasons for that. I can continue learning to fly. I could take out student loans for my college education. It was affordable. I think at the time I was actually switching. It was the number 2 most affordable aviation program in the college, in the country. and it might be number one right now.
It might be, yeah. But it is a very, very good price. Incredibly priced, that's for sure.
Polk State is a what people would have known as a community college. It's a state college in the state of Florida. Offers four-year degrees, but it's a commuter college. So it has a flexible schedule. The whole aerospace program is designed to be online. And it's one of those where they want you to succeed from all walks of life. If you're coming from the military, if you're coming out of high school, you can come into this program. You don't have to say goodbye to your family, I'm going back to college, and be there for 4 years to earn your certificates and get your education.
You know, I'm glad you brought that up, because if you look at some of the other videos that we've done, there's people from all walks of life. People that come from the Central Florida Aerospace Academy to those that are in the military working on jets, and other people that are from the military, from other careers. It's amazing the age range, too, of people that are actually on the team, which is very exciting. Brings a lot of depth and breadth to the team and also to Polk State College, that's for sure. So, Justin, what degree are you working towards now?
I am finishing in this semester, which is a couple months away. I am finishing my Bachelor's of Science in Aerospace Sciences.
Awesome. Well, I'll say congratulations ahead of time. So excited, excited to see that and see you, you know, walk down the aisle or however we're going to do it virtually. The certificates and ratings, though, you mentioned that you got your private. So a lot of the things you mentioned were online, the classes, but you do have to do some things in person. That's the flying part. So what did you earn at Polk State?
Yeah, I earned a lot at Polk State. Pre-COVID, I guess we have to put that out there, but you could still do it today. I moved out and earned my instrument rating, commercial pilot certificate, single engine. I earned my flight instructor and my double eye instrument privileges for the instructor all through Polk State.
So a lot of people that are, say, watching this may not know the aviation world. Tell us a little bit about some of the like really unique opportunities you've had because of the fact you are at Polk State.
Yes, so it's absolutely wonderful. Both my grandfathers were pilots, and I've never met one of them. Unfortunately, it was his plane accident that prevented that from happening. But the other one told me stories of aviation and inspired me to continue in my training. Well, I always wanted to take him flying. I always wanted to give back in a way I could. I don't have stories to tell except from what my training was. So I was able to arrange a flight to take my grandfather, who hadn't flown in over three decades, back in the air, back to go see the clouds, the birds, and actually see the airspace and the features that I had been telling the stories from.
And that was actually in one of the planes that the flight team had available to them to use for practice and to compete. And actually, it was used in the competition during that year. And we'll have some of those pictures of that opportunity. What an amazing opportunity that was. It's just so, so happy to see that you were able to do that with your grandfather to get him back in the air. And that's kind of making dreams come true. And that's what it's all about here at Polk State and also in the aviation world, that's for sure. Justin, let's talk a little bit about the team. And for those that are watching, you know, make sure you go to polkstateflightteam.com and check out all the other videos. And also, you know, if you're interested, help us, you know, maybe with a small donation so that we can do these kind of practices and stuff like this. But how long have you been here at the Polk State Flight Team?
Well, that's a fun story. I joined a week before competition, 2018. I guess that'd be 2.5 years now. What was it? Halloween, right before competition, I was wearing a Jurassic Park pilot uniform that I had made for that year's Halloween. And I had been told that there was a competitor who last minute couldn't attend competition and they needed a substitute. That was me.
And another opportunity just jumped in. You jumped on, which, you know, hats off to you for doing that. And that's kind of indicative of most of the people on the flight team. I think that they are really people that try to put themselves forth and work really hard. One of the things I love about the flight team, too, is that we truly do try to win, but win with integrity. And that is something that you've been able to bring forth as far as your term as captain. But, you know, you've been on the team for this long. How about moving back to either then or now, explain why the flight team, why you're on the flight team?
Why the flight team? In this moment, it feels like one of those passion projects that you'll do anything for. And again, like me wanting to become a pilot, being rooted in watching the space shuttle. I think this goes really far back. Growing up, I read Harry Potter, and this is going to be a stretch, but in the wizarding world of Harry Potter, there's a sport that's played on brooms, and so witches and wizards fly around playing this sport. It's called Quidditch. And I thought it was so cool as a kid to be able to, like, get all suited up and have, like, an old-school flying sport where you have goggles on and you're flying around, you get scarves on. It brings that old type of aviation back, the wing walkers, the biplanes, the barnstormers. And I just thought it would be cool to play a sport or compete while flying. I didn't even know I wanted to be a pilot then. After I got to Embry-Riddle, I saw an ad for their flight team, one of our competitors. And I was struggling with my landings, and I learned that, oh, they do landing competitions. Well, maybe I should join the flight team to improve my personal landings. My term at Embry-Riddle ended sooner than I expected, so I moved to Polk State. And eventually, rather than being captain of a Quidditch team, in this case, Hufflepuff is my house in Hogwarts, I became captain of the Polk State flight team, getting the opportunity to compete against a school that I trained at. And that's just one of the most ironic things I think I've ever done in my life.
What a great story. Oh, my gosh. From Quidditch to the flight team. That's incredible. You've changed shirts, and now you're actually the captain of the team. You know, that's one of the things that I think is true about aviation, is that it truly does allow us to have dreams come true and come to fruition, just manifest themselves just slightly differently than we may have expected. So if you're somebody who's interested in a flight team in general, I mean, not just here at Polk State, but what are some of the benefits to the students? If somebody's watching this right now, say a parent or somebody who, a donor, or somebody who's interested maybe in getting involved, what is the benefit to the actual student in participating in a flight team?
There's too many to say, but some of the most important on the surface are always going to be more flight time, being able to build your resume, build up that logbook, build those experiences. And actually, that's why a lot of students like to join the flight team. I think it goes a little bit further than that. You get a bunch of pilots, a bunch of aviators, I should say, together. They're studying. They are sharing stories. You have a community element to it. And then you have, especially with NIFA and SafeCon, the element of safety. You're not just all getting in an airplane and flying around for fun, although you can't have fun flying around in an airplane. But in the flight team, it's a bunch of people trying to push themselves to be safer, to be smarter, and to be the best of the best. That causes people, through competition or fun, to actually improve their skills without even realizing it.
Wow, and doing it while you're having fun, incredible opportunity to be on the flight team. You know, you talked about building hours. That's just one of the important things. In general, in a career, you know, something else, I was wondering maybe you could speak towards this, is that these competitions, a lot of people don't recognize them because they're wearing t-shirts and jeans a lot of times until one night they're wearing a suit and tie. Is all these folks that are there that are actually recruiting from the different airlines, were you able to actually interact with any of those folks, any of those recruiters?
I was, because there are judges. And apparently when you play ukulele in front of an entire conference of different flight teams, people remember your face. But yeah, I was competing in the scan competition. It's a multiple choice, big test with a lot of navigation questions and regulations. And I hadn't bubbled in a single answer. I was circling them on the page. I didn't want to deal with my answer sheet till the very end. And one of the judges started walking back and forth near my table more and more as the timer was getting closer and closer to being completely done. Didn't say anything, I bubbled in my test, turned it in, all was well. I go to the next competition, and it's the same guy. And it was the IFR simulator precision flying competition, task saturation, how well can you do? And he's just kind of watching us. At the end, he had casual conversation. He's asking us airliner questions, asking us questions about different instruments and procedures. And he turned and looked at me and he said, "You know, Justin, I was really rooting for you. You scared me a little bit. You didn't have a single question marked on your test until the very end, and I was afraid you were going to mess it up. I couldn't help you because I'm a judge, but I was watching you." And it was cool because all of a sudden I realized that these are the people that work for the airlines. These are the people looking for future airline pilots. But they're people too. And they start to look at everyone not only as another number, another pilot, but as who they are as a person. And just like flight instructors, just like mentors, parents, and even advisors, they were there at that competition to watch us succeed.
Yeah, and they really want you to succeed, that's for sure. And that's why we all do this. And whether it's recruiting for a certain airline or just in general trying to help people move forward, the folks that are judges, coaches, everybody involved in the National Intercollegiate Flight Association really wants people to succeed. You know, another part of that event that was really cool, I thought, was the fact that they actually had recruiters come in and do even interviews. And at many of the different events, I remember one year they actually brought a plane in and did the interviews in the airplane. I don't know if you were able to get involved with that one when we were at Auburn, but that was actually really interesting. But for somebody who's looking at, you know, if helping the team in some way, one of the big benefits, I think, is the fact that, yeah, you're in front of the recruiters. You learn how to talk to them. You learn so much about the fact that, like what you just said, is that they're real people, just like you and I. Yeah. And I think it helps you definitely during the interview process. And everybody knows NIFA. All the chief pilot's offices and that kind of thing know what the competitions are all about. You know, Justin, this has been awesome just having you on. But, you know, I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you, as far as the future, what's next for Justin?
What's next for Justin? You know, COVID's kind of thrown a Spaniard in the works. Interviews out the window, airline jobs promised and then unable to be fulfilled. But I honestly don't know. I haven't flown in 180 days. It's been a long time for me. I was flying every day as an instructor. It became a passion of mine to teach, to share aviation with people, and then it just went away. I have had time to focus on finishing my bachelor's, and that's going to be a good feeling. I've also recently, I guess partly because I'm trying to keep on my polishness that I used to have as an instructor, partly because I wanted to continue engaging with the aviation community, I stream on Twitch. For those of you who don't know, that's just a online digital entertainment media, basically live videos where you can interact with the person rather than YouTube where it's pre-recorded like this. But I started flying on Twitch just so that I could fly with my grandfather, just so that he can sit down and we go, "Hey, let's go fly here," and we tune in the radios or whatever. And he can watch me from wherever I was in the country. Now I have a whole following of people. In the long run, yes, I'm going to be instructing again. I'm going to be informing. I'm going to be flying airliner, space liner. In the short term, though, I think it's up in the air, quite literally.
I love that, up in the air. Well, you know, Justin, we're going to have all those links you talked about as far as Twitch, LinkedIn, and your website. Also, your Instagram. Love following you on there. And definitely check out, I love the picture of your grandfather and flying with him. Yeah. That was awesome. This is the reason we do this, is just to see smiling faces like yours and people like yourself succeed. And it's really an important part of being part of the team. So, Justin, thanks again for joining us. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having me. It's always wonderful talking to you, Carl.
Well, if you're interested in the flight team, or if you're somebody's interested in a flight team and want to know more about NIFA, the Intercollegiate Flight Association, the Polk State College flight team, and how it can benefit the students at Polk State and the students nationally, go to polkstateflightteam.com. And if you get a chance, check out the donations page. We have many different levels of donation. You can actually get on the shirt that Justin's wearing right there, and at a certain levels of donations. And all of our sponsors are on the shirt. And you too can be one of those sponsors that's on the shirt and show your pride by sponsoring a flight team. Well, really appreciate your listening and watching to this. Don't forget that there's a lot of other videos out there from Meet the Team, all the different folks, and we're going to be doing more of these throughout the year. And we're going to try to stream a little bit of live at the competition and take some video. Even if it's not live, we'll put it out there just so you know what it's like to be in a competition, what are the different events, that type of thing. And that's what we're going to do for you. Well, I really appreciate you watching this video. I'm Carl Valeri, the coach of the Polk State College flight team. Don't forget to go visit polkstateflightteam.com.